Good day everyone, I am Leobert Lomar from BSIS course, and our group is assigned to discuss the topic of computer crime. So, what is computer crime? Basically, computer crime is an act of a crime usually using a computer to blackmail or bully someone, terrorism, hacking, or either to force someone to commit a suicide. Nowadays, internet is one of the best way to communicate someone, either it from another country, as long the place has an internet. But on the other side, internet widened computer crime, because you can easily blackmail or bully someone by sending them a message or posting them on a social media. Acts using computer or computer-related technologies that fall within the limits that the legislature of states or a nation has specified or considered illegal and may lead to forfeiture or certain civil rights of the predator. The United States, local states, and federal legislature have defined such acts to include such as the following: intrusion into public packet networks, network integrity violation, privacy violation, industrial or financial espionage, pirated computer software, computer-aided fraud, internet or email abuse, using computer or computer technologies to commit murder, terrorism, pornography, hacking, and many other crimes. Cybercriminal may infect computer with viruses and malware to damage device or stop them working. Also, they're using malware to delete or steal data on your computer to commit a crime, like for example is blackmailing. They steal your information, picture, or video to use against you. Now, let's proceed to the history of computer crimes. On the history of computer crimes, viruses and hacking are the most common on computer crimes. Sometimes they became one when the hacker used viruses to attack your computer or devices. The word viruses is from a Latin word means poison. It weakening the body and lose its ability to fight foreign invader. But viruses is designed to destroy computer system resources, including data and hardware. What is hacking? Hacking is another crime that utilize the internet working between computers and communication devices. But as long the computer are not interconnected in network, hacking cannot perform. Hacking begins with the invention of telephone in 1876 by Alexander Graham Bell. However, there was a long gap between the invention of the telephone and the first recorded hacking in 1971. In the mid of 1980s, the first notable system penetration attack started in San Francisco, 414 Club. 414 Club was the first national news-making hacker group. Their group name was based on the area code of San Francisco. They started the series of computer attack using the Stanford University computer and spread the attack across the country. The 1990s saw heightened hacking activities and serious computer network near meltdown, including the 1971 expectation of the Michelangelo virus that was expected to crash computer on March 6, 1992. In 1995, the person named Kevin Mitnick was arrested by the FBI for stealing of 1,000 credit cards number. And also, Pentagon was attacked by Ehud Tinabuem, an Israel teenager known as the Analyzer. In 1999, President Bill Clinton announced a $1.46 billion initiative to improve government computer security. The year 2000 probably went down in history as one of the years that saw the most costly and most powerful computer network attack. It included Melissa, Lovebug, Killer Resume, and the Code Red in 2001. Two factors have contributed to this phenomenal growth: the growth of the internet and the massive news converge of various incident.
My name is Giovanni Moreno and I will discuss the types of computer system attacks. Number one, we have penetration. Penetration attack is breaking into computer system to gather vulnerable access or information. With full penetration attack, the intruder can break into your computer system and gain access that can alter files, change data, and plant viruses, and installing a Trojan horse program that can control or remote your computer system. Number two, we have DDoS attack. DDoS attack is a commonly used attack to a computer system. This is a type of attack that used to a company or internet to slow or disturb the normal function of a target or victim. DDoS attack aim usually to exhaust the network bandwidth, its router capacity, or network stack resources, thus eventually breaking the network connectivity of target or the victim. That is the end of my presentation, and let's go for the next one.
Hi guys, my name is Mark Angelo de los Arcos, and my topic for today is motives of computer crime and cause and social consequences. Motives of computer crimes. There are numerous obvious reasons why people hack. Recently, the number of cases for hackings, illegal financial gain, or other malicious purposes has increased. Let's talk about the various types of motives. Different kinds of motives. The political activism refers to a cyber crime committed by individuals, by groups, or a nation state in furtherance for some political goals or agenda. There are many factors that contribute to political activism, but they can be summed up as hack activism. The next one is vendetta. Can occur in situation involving family and intimacy issues. Next is joke or hacks. Hacks are scare alerts by one or more malicious peoples and then pass on to the innocent user who believe they are helping the community by doing so. The next is hackers' ethics. A collection of motives that make hackers' character. Next is extortion or terrorism. Defined as a cyber-dependent committed crime for a political purposes in order to steal, fear, intimidate, and curse a target for a government or population and to cause of the threatened harm. Next is political, military, and espionage. Our reliance on computers in the national, military, and commercial establishments has created a new suitable habitat for a espionage. The next is business and industrial espionage. Economic and industrial espionage is on the rise around the world as a business and the countries compete for a global dominance. Next topic is cause and social consequence. Easy availability of hackers tool. There are estimated 300 hackers oriented websites in the internet that advertise and distribute free hackers tools of looking tips. One is anonymity. Hacker tracing and operation have become more difficult as computers become smaller and people with this small internet connected gizmos have become more mobile. Next one is cut and paste programming technology. This space has removed the most significant independent that has kept many would-be hackers from trying their hand and trades. Next one is communication speed. With the most recent advancements in bandwidth, large amounts of data can move in the shortest amount of time. High degrees of internet working. All of these internet works are linked via internet, and the internet access is available via readily available and inexpensive internet capable in mobile devices. Increasing dependency on computers. Hackers now have a fertile ground to work on.
I am John Andre Titofalia reporting you the computer crime prevention strategies. Preventing computer crime is not a simple thing to do, because to do that one needs to understand how these crimes are committed and who is involved in these crimes. To prevent such crimes, we need to focus on three entities: the computer as a tool used to commit the crimes, the criminal who is the source of the crime, and the innocent victim of the crime. protecting your computer. Physical protective measures. Locate the computer and data storage away from outside windows. Install strong doors and locks to the computer room to prevent equipment theft and tampering. Reinforce interior walls to prevent break-ins. Restrict access to computer facilities to authorized personnel. Procedural and operational protective measures. If you take the computer as the main tool in the execution of the crime, this leads us to find those elements of the computer that are more susceptible to being the good conduit. The list of these items may include data, software, media, services, and hardware. Classify information to categories based on importance and confidentiality. Use labels such as confidential and sensitive. Install software access control mechanism. Encrypt confidential data stored in computers or transmitted over communication networks. Establish procedures for recovering your operating system if it is destroyed. Store all backup data off-site. Review automated audit information and control reports to determine if they have been repeated. Protection. Antivirus is a kind of software used to prevent, scan, detect, and delete viruses from a computer. The following measures can help protect your computer from viruses. Number one, do not bring this in from outside sources. Number two, scan demo disk from vendors, shareware, or freeware sources for viruses. Restrict use of electronic bulletin boards. Number five, scan downloaded files for viruses. Avoid downloading executable files. And the last, make regular backups to aid in recovery.
Good day, everyone. This is Diane reporting the computer criminal and the innocent victim. Let's start with the computer criminal. These are individuals or teams of people who use technology to commit malicious activities of stealing sensitive company information or personal data and generating profit. And these are the examples of computer criminals such as identity thieves, internet stalkers, phishing scammers, or cyber terrorists. Fast Computer Crime Prevention Laws provides rules of conduct and standards of behavior for use of internet, computers, and related digital technologies and the action of the public, government, and private organizations. Accordingly, computer crime law includes substantive, procedural, and preventive law. Enforcement of criminal laws is also not untouched by technological advances, and how cybercrime is battled will also be a defining issue in the coming decades. Moral education, giving the importance of the information technology in the practices of today's universities, and given the possibilities of unethical use of this technology by students and staff, universities should ensure that they have policies regarding the use of management of information technology by student and staff. The innocent victim. The following measures should be focused on the victims of computer crimes. In the three parts of personal policies, such as monitoring, security, and established rules. And the last part, educating the computer user. We need to educate the user to be aware of possible sources of computer crime and what to do if and when one becomes a victim of a computer crime. And that is my part. Once again, this is the end.